Thunderbolt hubs are a great way to add more ports to your computer or also just to simplify your setup by allowing a ton of devices to be plugged into one port on your machine. And in this video, we're going to take a look at the CalDigit Element 5 Thunderbolt 5 hub. This is a fantastic compact hub. Look at how small it is next to the M4 Mac Mini. I'm amazed at all the power that CalDigit was able to pack into this. You plug one Thunderbolt cable into your device and then you get three extra Thunderbolt ports, a USB-A port on the back, and then you also get two USB-C ports and two USB-A ports on the front of it. This will also keep a laptop charged with up to 90 watts of power going out the cable. So this is a fantastic option to keep high resolution displays and high speed peripherals plugged into your Mac computer. I do want to say CalDigit sent me the Element 5 for free for purposes of making this video. They have no input in this content. This is going to be my thoughts on who the Element 5 is for and who should maybe look for a larger dock instead of the Element 5. So whenever I got this out of the box, I was amazed at just how small the Element 5 actually is. Here it is next to the M4 Mac Mini. This is technically a Thunderbolt 5 hub, which is going to support speeds all the way up to 80 gigabits a second, which is amazing if you're wanting to plug high-speed SSDs into the back of this because you're going to be able to take advantage of their top speeds. Even when I tested this with the new Acasus Thunderbolt 5 SSD enclosure, I was still hitting almost the top speeds on that enclosure, almost 6,000 megabytes a second, which is crazy to be able to do that with a hub. And I also had the Apple Studio Display plugged into this, another Thunderbolt 4 dock, and other peripherals as well, and it was still giving enough bandwidth to do that. Another great advantage of Thunderbolt 5 is Thunderbolt 5 actually supports up to 120 gigabits a second of bandwidth, which is a boost setting that will allow more bandwidth to go towards displays. I think where the Element shines is to keep multiple high resolution displays plugged into your computer while still giving you plenty of extra ports to do basically whatever you want with it. This is a very great companion with the Mac Mini, also the Mac Studio, and it'll work with the MacBook Air, the MacBook Pro as well. There's just a few things you might be missing with this versus getting something like a dock, but we'll get there in a sec. What I really love about this dock is now with Thunderbolt 5, you can actually daisy chain two studio displays on the one hub. So one port plugged into your computer is going to give you dual 5K displays. Of course, this will also support other 8K displays, 4K monitors. There's tons of different displays this will support. The main thing to note with the Element 5 is your total number of displays and the bandwidth that's going to be available to this is going to be dependent on the computer you're running it with. So this is actually the Mac Mini M4 base model, which only has Thunderbolt 4, but this is still going to perform at those Thunderbolt 4 speeds. But whenever I've been running this with my Mac Studio behind me, that's when I'm able to take advantage of all the extra bandwidth that this provides. This will also work with phones and also with all the iPads using USB-C. The speeds are just going to be limited by the various ports on the devices. So CalDigit has done a great job at making a compact hub that works with pretty much anything. A couple more features about the hub we want to note. On the front of it, you do get USB ports, 2A and 2C, and all the USB ports on this support power up to 7.5 watts, so it'll be a great option to keep power-hungry devices working great, like I've been using it with my Stream Deck, works great with that. And then on the back of it is where we get the three Thunderbolt 5 ports, and we also get another USB-A port. So all the USB-A ports give you 10 gigabit per second speeds and 7.5 watts. They put the computer port on the side of this, which is kind of interesting. They give you these little rubber feet to elevate it off your surface. So you can either put it in this orientation, plug in on that side, or you can also flip it, plug in on that side. The main thing I really think CalDigit missed out with this is I wish they would have put a Thunderbolt port on the front of this. That's what's missing from the Mac Mini and also from the Mac Studio. No Thunderbolt ports on the front of it. Technically, you could run it this way, use this as the front side, and then just have the power coming out of the front. That's totally an option as well. It also would have been really cool if they could have made a way to have the power go through a USB port and use some sort of external power supply. But I do love a DC brick like this because you get a really strong connection. You don't have to worry about it falling out. And these power bricks are just able to really pump out tons of wattage. Also, CalDigit did a great job with this power supply. It's smaller than their older supplies, and the brick on it is almost the same size as this. Some of the power bricks for hubs and docks just get really big, bulky and unwieldy, which makes them not as good for travel. One thing I will note about the Element 5 is the power brick makes it a little bit annoying to travel with, but you can totally stuff this away in a bag or a suitcase if you really need the extra ports and expansion of this. But I think where the Element 5 is really designed for and where it really shines is on a desktop setup when you want to be able to keep several different devices set up, have some sort of Thunderbolt chain set up with your Mac Studio, your Mac Mini, your MacBook Pro. I like to use this to go back and forth between my MacBook Pro and my Mac Studio. And you can actually buy an extra Thunderbolt cable, and then you can just swap the cable, have both of them plugged into your computer, swap which one's plugged into the side of this. So It almost makes it like a little computer switch to use with the desktop setup. So in the box, you get the Element 5, a nice Thunderbolt 5 cable, and you also get the power brick. I've tested this with a variety of computers from the Mac Mini, the Mac Studio, the M4 MacBook Air, and also an M1 Max MacBook Pro. It worked great with all of them. Again, the speeds you're gonna get with this and the devices connected with it are just gonna depend on what your device natively supports. So this has had no issue with actually plugging in both a LG UltraFine 5K display and an Apple Studio display when I ran it with my Mac Studio. And CalDigit has a whole chart on their website too, which helps you know the difference between all the different Mac computers and how many displays they're gonna support. If you use this with something like an M1 or an M2 or an M3 MacBook Air, you're only gonna be able to use one external display. But if you use this with the Mac Studio, the new Mac Mini, the new MacBook Air, this will support multiple displays. So depending on your setup, make sure you check the chart on their website to ensure that it will be compatible with the number of displays you wanna run with it. This also provides up to 90 watts of power using the Thunderbolt 5 cable. And whenever I was testing this with my MacBook Pro M1 Max, it had no problems with keeping the computer charged while I was using it. So plenty of power out of the host port on this. You could also get two of these and stack them together for even more ports and daisy chain them. That's one of the great advantages of Thunderbolt 5. Or I was testing this out with a couple of my other Thunderbolt docks, and all of those docks were performing just as expected, even running them after this last in the chain. The CalDigit Element 5 retails for $250 at the time of filming this video, and at this time, there's really no competition with this hub. This gives you the faster Thunderbolt 5 speeds, 5 USB ports, and the host port being separate, plenty of power for your computer, so you can keep tons of devices all plugged in at the same time, no matter what you're using. I think this is gonna be ideal for M4 Mac Mini or M4 Pro Mac Mini users who need a couple more Thunderbolt ports than what this is able to offer, because if you start to plug displays and other devices in, the 3 Thunderbolt ports are gonna be used up really fast on this. It'll also be a great option if you have high speed SSDs, whether USB 4, Thunderbolt 3, 4, or 5 SSDs, it's gonna give you maximum speed and power when plugging those into your computer. Another thing I think this is great for is for MacBook Pro or MacBook Air users who wanna go back and forth between using a computer and a desktop computer, and to only have to change one cable out and to keep a ton of other things plugged in. What this is really missing when you compare it to a dock is there's no Ethernet connectors, no audio outs, and there's also no HDMI or DisplayPort plugged in. But I think it's worth noting that you can always use the Thunderbolt ports on the back to do pretty much whatever you want, whether it's extra USB ports or if you need to adapt it to a very fast 10 gigabit a second Ethernet port or an audio port. You can adapt the USB-C jacks or the Thunderbolt jacks to pretty much whatever you want. It just means more dongles or adapters to use. But I think that's where the Element 5 really shines, is the compact size, the power and flexibility that you get with this to do basically whatever you want. There's tons of bandwidth with this, and it runs fine even under a heavy load of running multiple 5K displays, multiple fast enclosures. I had no issues with this, and it was just chugging along, giving me the fastest possible speeds. At the time of filming this, CalDigit does not have a Thunderbolt 5 dock, so if you wanna have those fastest possible speeds to allow you to daisy chain more devices, even higher bandwidth than Thunderbolt 4, this is gonna be the best option for you. But if you're running a laptop and you really need some of those additional ports, you might wanna consider looking for a dock instead. So this is gonna be for the user who wants more USB and Thunderbolt ports, power for your computer, and the fastest possible bandwidth for keeping other devices plugged in. It'll work great whether you're using it with the Mac Studio, the Mac Mini, the MacBook Pro, or the MacBook Air. It's just gonna be the best with a desktop computer, but it's also still gonna give you plenty of power and expansion for your laptop computers. If you're interested in buying the CalDigit Element 5, I do have links to buy in the description below. If you got any other questions about this, leave a comment down below. I'll do my best to answer them. Like this video, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any upcoming content.